Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Family Outings TV. This evening we are off to KYNREN Firework Spectacular. Now, KYNREN normally is a venue in Durham, holds 8,000 people, and it's usually a historic storytelling show. It's amazing. I would definitely recommend that in the summer of 2020. However, this evening it is a firework spectacular. Half an hour fireworks spectacular, so I'm interested in seeing what this event is like. I do have some gripe with KYNREN. It's certainly not a family friendly venue. I do feel that they are literally out to rinse you for as much money as possible. Reasons for that: food and drink on site is extremely expensive. You can't take your own food and drink onto site. And they do try and get you there just as early as possible. So you need to arrive 2 hours early. The buses stop running 2 hours before the show starts. So I just don't think it's really a family-friendly venue. Hopefully this evening they might prove me a little bit wrong. I mean, there's no doubt that the KYNREN show itself is a great spectacle in the summer. I wonder what tonight will be like. So we will we'll go take a look. Hello, Izzy and Riley.
Hello.
Right, we're here at KYNREN, the fireworks spectacular. What are you looking forward to?
The show.
The show?
The
yeah.
Fireworks.
Do you like fireworks? Riley, I've just got some news, just in.
What?
The firework display is around movies.
I didn't know that.
I know you didn't know that. What's your favourite movie of all time?
Toy Story 4.
Do you think so? Izzy, if you could pick any song from a movie to go with fireworks, what would it be?
I think it would have to be Rewrite the Stars.
Oh, nice.
Rewrite the Stars, a good one. Oh, we'll have to see. We'll have to see if that is involved in this firework display.
Mm-hmm.
And what are you up to, cheeky chappy? What are you doing? What are you doing?
Eating.
Give me your best firework dance. All right.
But,
nice. Give me your firework dance. Oh yeah.
Nice.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Oh, I like the sound.
Right, so straight ahead you can see the temporary 8,000 seater stand that has actually been here for about 4 years now, I think. Holds 8,000 people. Just have a little scroll around. Now, as anticipated, we're here an hour and a half early, and literally the only thing for kids to do is eat or drink. Just think, it's not family friendly at all. The food prices aren't actually as bad as they usually are, so I will say that in regards to the things that are run by KYNREN. But you can see the ones that I'm looking at now over here, like the waffles, chicken, baked potatoes, they seem to be all like concessions, so they are quite expensive. You're looking at like £6 for a hog roast bun, a small hog roast bun. So if you are with a family, it does end up being very expensive. As I say, I just think they could have put some things on for children. Bearing in mind, they told most people that the last bus here is at 5 o'clock. The show doesn't start till 7. So you're going to be here at least like an hour and a half with nothing to do for the kids.
I'm here.
Right, so here we are, the morning after the night before. Normally we do a recording straight after the attraction or the event, but last night it was pouring down and it was very difficult to exit the venue. So you will have seen the fireworks, absolutely amazing, amazing fireworks show, great music, great theming, cannot fault it at all. Kids loved it, really an amazing show. Lasted about 30 minutes, which is a good chunk of time for the fireworks. To summarise though, again, I was a little bit disappointed in a few things. The price of food and things for families to do as you entered was a bit disappointing. I think it'd be nice if there was, like, in some of the food stalls, things at kids' prices, so kids' portions, kids' prices, around about the £3 mark. I would have liked maybe something, anything at all for the kids to do. A play area, some rides, some arts and crafts things, anything like that, because they were asking people to get on site very, very early. Exiting the venue and attraction was an absolute nightmare for my father. He was in a wheelchair, so I was pushing him. There was no kind of things taken for people to leave early in wheelchairs so they could get out quicker. And it was literally just like a big cattle market, so you couldn't move at all. I mean, with a wheelchair trying to get through crazy crowds, it was just a nightmare. And even if you weren't in a wheelchair, they could have done with some kind of staging, so maybe part of the stand leaves at one time before the other. Just a little bit better management in leaving the venue. Again, I don't really want to, it does seem a bit negative, don't want to criticise it because it was an amazing event, really good event. I just think maybe a little bit more thought for families and exiting the venue would have been great. But big thumbs up overall. Hope you liked the footage. Please like, subscribe. That would be much appreciated as we add more and more videos. Thanks very much for watching and we'll see you again soon. Bye!